This is a video showing how to import FLS files inside of Geomagic Design X and Geomagic Wrap. The first thing you need to do is go to our support page and find the file import converters page. You can search this through Google, or you can go to Geomagic support and go to downloads, file import converters, and then you can end up on this page. You'll see a little bit down here, we have the Faro FLS, FWS, LS project files, and you can see what version and what products that they work with. Now the interesting thing is there are two files that you need to download for wrap and control. You have to download our importer itself, which is going to write to the product and make it aware that this right here, the driver or SDK that Faro puts out, are linked together. So you have to download both of these files, install them, and once you do, Geomagic Wrap will be able to open FLS files. Now, for DX, if you just install the driver, this guy right here, that'll allow DesignX to import FLS files. So once you're done with that, I'm going to go to DX first. Opening an FLS file, I'm going to go ahead and just drag it in here. And you'll see that when you bring in an FLS file, it's going to have a slightly different dialogue that pops up. Right here, it's just going to ask you what range. You can actually dictate that it doesn't bring in the full spherical grid and bring that in. So if you hit OK, I'm just going to tell it to bring in everything. And you'll see that it will have the point cloudy over here on the left-hand side. Now, once this gets in here, there are two different methods for meshing a spherical point cloud. One of them is using our new HD mesh construction, which was designed specifically to tackle projects where you'll want to mesh terrestrial data or long range data. Another method, which is a slightly older method, is you can use our spherical grid meshing algorithm. So I can bring that in. So you see right away, this is the data. And I'm just going to crop some data out because we don't need to mesh everything for this. I'll just go ahead and do a box select. And we're going to use that data. We'll inverse and delete. So I'll go ahead and remove some of these trees too, actually. Just do this. Use the front facade. All right, so if I want to, I'll show you the traditional, the older method first, just to understand that, how that works. So if I have only one point cloud, then you're going to use triangulate. If you have multiple point clouds, you're going to use merge. There are many of the same options in both, but I'll just cover triangulation right now. The first option I'll show is the older method, where we can actually, under 2D triangulation, do a spherical mesh. You can input the center point manually, but you'll notice that the software automatically knows where the scan position is based on that point cloud and how it imports. There are all these options here. As you can see, you can set the maximum edge length, the area of the triangle, the ratio of the edge to edge of the triangles, and then the angle between the projection direction. So I tend to mesh with just using the maximum edge. And what I will do is I'll zoom in and you can kind of see the object that I'm looking at trying to mesh. I'll just use the maximum edge and I will measure and just get a general idea of like the point distance. So you can see here, if I just hit measure 34, so I can just maybe just round it to like 40 or something. So I'm just going to say you're allowed to make triangles that have a edge length of 40. So I'm just giving it the freedom to connect those together. And then these larger strays, these will just be small clusters. And then turn off remove original data. I want to keep that just to make sure. And then I just plug in what point cloud it is that I want to run it on and then hit OK. So now it'll go ahead and calculate the mesh based on the spherical method. Okay, there we are. So if I zoom in, you can see that I went ahead and enmeshed it. And if I go to display, turn off texture, you can see there's the texture, the polygons themselves without the color texture on it. Now, what I will do with the traditional method is, you know, crop everything that I need to crop. And then I'll take each individual mesh and I will merge them at the end. So again, that's the older method for creating a mesh. Now, the newer method is we created an HD mesh. We created an HD mesh triangulation format. Now this is designed specifically for long range data, and you can use this under merge too. So with this newer method, you can select a bunch of clouds and tell it to merge them all together into one mesh. So if I come in here, I leave my settings very default, right in the middle there. You can slide up and change the definition and noise. The noise reduction is going to remove more noise, and it's very powerful. So if you move this up one notch, it's going to remove a lot of noise. And then this is going to dictate kind of the output resolution of the mesh. And then remove original data, I'm going to turn it off. And then extend boundaries, it's going to give it freedom to do a lot of hole filling, because long range data, you have large gaps between data. So I usually turn this all the way down to less, and then I turn it curved or flat, whatever my preference is for this object. So for this, I might just do flat because it's a building. So I'll go ahead and hit merge, and you'll see that it creates a slightly different looking mesh, which is a little smoother. This algorithm works a little bit faster as well because we've tuned it for large data sets. Okay, so you'll see it's a lighter weight mesh, lower resolution. And the more point clouds I have, the more resolution it will have. And again, you can slide the UHD, HD, and get a higher resolution mesh. But this is designed to go fast and create a mesh from huge point clouds. So it does a good job, but you'll notice it is very smooth. So that is how you process just a very basic data set inside of DesignX. So now I'll move over to Wrap. All right, so for Wrap, when you install those two files, the Faro SDK and the plugin, you're able to drag FLS files in. So I'm just going to drag one in. And it will pop up with a dialog in a similar fashion to DesignX, but it's going to have some of those filtering options upon import. Another thing it's going to do is it's also going to bring the point cloud in as ordered data instead of unordered data in Wrap. So anyone that has used Wrap out there, you know that there are two different types of point cloud information, ordered data and unordered data. Ordered data, one of the biggest benefits is it's an ordered uniform grid where it knows it's the points know their neighbors as well as their position, XYZ, IJK, RGB, all those things. So when you bring this in, you can actually turn on and off these edge length options here. So you can see that I can do 0.3. I'm just going to tell it to only filter by edge length. So I'm going to say, don't connect points together that are longer than that 0.3 millimeters. And you'll see here in a minute, I turn off fill holes and load as unordered data. So you can override it and load unordered data. And then you can even sample the ratio where it will take every fourth point. Nice, you see there. So I'm just going to keep it at 1:1 and hit OK. Now it will go ahead and bring that in as ordered data. If you have unordered data, it's still possible to process it, but you'll need to run a bunch of point cloud filters to reduce the outliers and everything in order to get a acceptable point cloud. And the reason behind that is the meshing algorithm in here was fine-tuned for short-range data, not necessarily long-range information. So you'll want to run through the point cloud tools and do the noise reduction and things like that and outlier removal manually and then process it through. So for today, I'm just going to show ordered data processing because this is the preferred method. I'm going to go in and select just the area of interest, reverse selection, and remove everything else. And then we'll get rid of from the top side. We'll do a similar mesh. Oops. I didn't have select through on. So let's look at it again. I'll clear that selection. There. So if I turn off my texture just to show, you can see that it is a point cloud, but they're in a uniform grid and they know their neighbors. Again, that makes it a more intelligent point cloud for the software to work with, and it saves a ton of time processing when you bring it in as ordered data. You'll also notice the icon is different. It's this ordered grid. So you can bring in a bunch of ordered data sets, crop them down, and run merge instead of wrap, just like we have in the other product. But today, because I have just one ordered data set, I'm going to go ahead and wrap it. And you'll see that the data looks a little better that way. So I'm going to go ahead, just remove some noise there, and hit wrap. And you'll see that it's already done into a point cloud. You'll see that you can see the edges and stuff. Now, if I again turn off the vertex color, the mesh that it creates is beautiful when you bring it in as ordered data. And again, if I have multiple sets, I can then take all these individual polygon sets and merge them together. And then this will help you get a better usable data set to model off of. So that's just the basics of importing FLS data into Wrap and DesignX, and a couple tips and tricks on how to process that data properly inside of those packages. Depending on the application, there are variations of this workflow, and I know that exists, but this is really just intended to show you the basic methods for bringing in a data set into Wrap and DesignX.